So this is Chris with the Crutchfield Tech Support Department. Today I'm here to show you about installing a capacitor to protect the mid-range on this two-way speaker. Supplied by the manufacturer, like a little black tube. It's got a lead coming off each end of it. Gonna need some heat shrink tubing, a bit of rosin core solder, and the provided connector that we usually send with most orders. Has to go in line on the positive wire. So we're going to make our cut for the wire here, about halfway down the lead. Then we'll need to strip approximately a half inch of insulation off of each side of the wire. All right, so we're going to put our heat shrink tubing on the wire and attach the copper to the tensile lead of the capacitor. First, twisting that around there on the end. And then we'll use our needle nose pliers as a heat sink. Prop that up. Then with the soldering iron, we'll add a bit of rosin core solder to the connection. Soak in a little bit, not too much, we don't need a lot. That's one connection down. And we'll add our second piece of wire, which we're reassembling, over to the other end of our capacitor. So slide your tubing on, twist the copper around the tensile lead of the capacitor. Then use your needle nose as a heat sink. Also does a nice little job of clamping the wire together with the end of the terminal of the capacitor. And then we can do the same thing we did on the other side by adding a bit of rosin core solder into the terminal. Go. Just a little dab will do you. Spread that through the wire slightly. There we go. And our second connection is made. I'm going to cool that off a little bit. Remove our heat sink. Slide the heat shrink tubing up over the wire to cover the wire and the capacitor's tensile lead. And we'll end up with something looking a little bit like this. And you can use almost any source of heat to shrink our tubing down. We want to reduce it in size. So I use, in this case, I'm using the barrel of the soldering iron. Once that's shrunk down a bit, turn off our soldering iron, and we're ready to attach it to the speaker. On the speaker, we have a larger terminal for our positive. Slide that on there. Smaller terminal for our negative. Slide that on there. All right, so there we have it. The speaker's ready to install and plug into our vehicle. If you have any questions, give our advisors a contact call or go onto our website at crutchfield.com. We'll be happy to help you out. Take care.